thank you for coming to conversation
no
to
problem.
Our show. Tell me, for the beginning, what were your reasons for coming to Serbia?
Well, I met my now wife, Anya. She's from Novi Sad, and we met in Canada, in high school actually, and we became friends, and in university we started dating seriously at the end of university, and I came here to spend some time with her and see what it was like where she was from. I also like to travel, and so for me it was kind of a nice place to come and visit, an interesting place to come and see that maybe is not something you'd immediately think of as a tourist destination or a place to visit even in Europe. So it was a really also great chance to see a part of the world that is maybe a little off the beaten path, so to speak.
Kako si odlučila da odeš za Kanadu prvi put?
Pa moj tata živeo u Kanadi, dok sam ja još odrastala, dok sam bila dete i odlazila sam tamo svakog leta na raspust. I onda sam 2004. onako odlučila da probam da tamo završim srednju školu, ovde sam završila 3 godine Jovine gimnazije i onda sam tamo otišla u 4. godinu srednje škole.
Šta si očekivao od Srbije pre nego što si došao?
Samo malo. To nisam ja. I don't usually have an impression before I come. And so when I come I just try and experience and understand with a very blank slate, so without so much of an impression. Mm-hmm. And so when I first arrived in Serbia, it was almost, I don't know, overwhelming a bit, because it's a little bit chaotic, there's a lot going on, and it's very expressive culture, so there's a lot coming towards you at once, and so it took me a little bit to kind of find my comfort in it, and to kind of more understand a bit what was happening and how people were talking to me and how everything was coming at me all at once, and that was just normal.
Kako je tebi izgledala Kanada, to prilagođavanje, razlike?
Strašno, strašno mi izgledalo. Života nekog koji je bio pun nekog, najbolji period je kraj srednje škole, grad, društvo, dečko, sve je bilo fenomenalno. I onda nekako je sve to presečeno onako bilo, jako traumatično u stvari, kad sad gledamo nazad.
Da li ti je žena bila, tadašnja devojka, bila dobar vodič kroz Novi Sad i sve ostalo u Srbiji?
Što znači vodič? Guide?
Vodič, guide, yeah.
Guide? I think so, yes, yeah. She is very passionate about Serbia, so, and she really, for her it's very important that I understand the culture and who she is and where she came from, which I really respect, and so in that sense she really tries to make it understandable for me, and we really try and explore a lot of those things and travel around and see different places and have lots of experiences that way, so it's good, yes.
Kako ste se ti i Tim upoznali?
Tim i ja smo se upoznali u srednjoj školi prvih dana kad se ja krenula tamo. On je bio onako spavao na svim časovima. Ja sam sve burno slušala i kao mali štreber, kao i uvek.
Upropizivao od tebe, kako to
više? Ne, njega to sve nije interesovalo i onda je bilo jako zanimljivo da ga je naš učitelj rekao, ajde Tim, sad kad stalno spavaš, izađi i ispričaj sve što ja treba da ispričam do kraja časa, i on je ustao i sve ispričao. On je sve to znao i onda je to meni već bilo fascinantno. Da.
Odlično govoriš srpski, kako si počeo da ga učiš?
Ja sam bio u filosofski fakultet at the University of Novi Sad for some Serbian classes za inostranstvo. But now I'm actually learning most with Pepa Prase, because my son is watching Pepa Prase na srpskom. Ja sam slušao i učim tako.
Koje su ti reči bile problem? Da li se sećaš nekih koje su ti bile teške u početku ili sada?
The ones with lots of changing syllables, where they're hard syllables. Kako se kaže? I can't even remember.
Saučesnik.
Support, I think.
Podrška?
Oh, that one too. That's another one. Let's see. I get lost.
Hard language, right?
Yeah. There's some things that are very nice and easy, like one letter, one sound. That's great. But some of the words, we say tongue twisters, right? Your tongue gets in a knot and then you're hopeless.
Koliko je prošlo vremena do tvog prvog povratka u Srbiju i kako ti je onda Srbija izgledala?
Da, godinu dana je prošlo, znači možda čak i najduže. Posle sam dolazila uvek na 3-4 meseca. Ta prva godina je bila onako najduža. Srbija mi je izgledala divno. I sad mi izgleda divno.
I dalje izgleda divno.
Da, divno.
What would you like to change in Serbia?
The bureaucracy, maybe that's the one. That's, I think, common ground between visitors and people from Serbia, is that sometimes when you have to register when you arrive and things like this, it's sometimes not so easy. And if you're living here, it's also not so easy, right? So.
Kada si dovela tima prvi put u Srbiju?
Nisam ga ja dovela, on je došao sam. Pa 2009. godine na exit. Ja sam već prešla u Švedsku na master. I onda sam stalno pričala o exit timu. To je bilo nešto poznato po meni, nekako neophodno da neko to proživi. I onda je on došao 2009. godine, prvi put na exit.
Da li si slušao neku srpsku muziku?
Da, ja volim EKB i Darko Rundek, Kustovic. Goran Bregović. Balkan music, I like. It's very lively, right? Mm-hmm. And tamburashi, you have so many influences. So it's nice to listen to. For me, I really like music, and Balkan music is passionate music. So mm-hmm. you can really feel that, even if you don't understand the language a lot of the time, especially because it's poetic, mm-hmm. it's hard to understand, you can feel the song still, which I really appreciate. So it's good.
U kome je sliven tvoga snijega slati moje tuge van. A zapinje u krošnji novih pitanja. Odgovor će doći možda ove noći prije svitanja. Gdje te čekam ja?
Kako mu izgledao exit tvrđava?
Fenomenalno, fenomenalno. Mislim da mu bilo sve to otkrovenje, zato što nema pravila, to je nešto što je jako lepo. Možda i za mlade ljude još više nema tih onako, tamo nekako prvo učite šta se sme i ne sme, ovde je nekako sloboda. Jako je, jako dobro ta muzika i tvrđava samo mesto. Fenomenalno izgledala, mislim da je uživao.
We're on place where was your wedding.
Yes.
And what about music on your wedding? Was there only some rock and roll or Serbian Balkan traditional music also?
It was a good mix. We had a very good band. And the funny thing for me, you asked this question, the funny thing for me is that a lot of times the band is popular in both Serbia and North America or Canada. But a lot of times the popular song is a little different. Mm-hmm. So sometimes a cover band here or our wedding band would play a song and I would recognize the band, but it wouldn't be the popular song from Canada. So it's always a little bit of a jump for me. But it's nice because you hear different things, and the other thing is that when it's popular here, everybody loves it and you really enjoy it regardless. So mm-hmm. it was good.
Odlučili ste da se venčate ovde, čuli smo od njega zašto.
Da.
Kako ste se oko muzike dogovorili i šta će da se svira na toj svadbi?
Pa, venčali ste se i tamo i ovde. Crkveno venčanje je bilo ovde, a tamo je bilo građansko. Pa nismo imali taj problem. Band nas je prosto, odlučili smo se za band koji je fenomenalan, koji je svirao stranu muziku. Kao bez akcenta su pevali, jako je bilo lepo. Tako da, nekako, nazvao je i naš brak, nemamo osjećaj kao da je to neka dva sveta koja se spajaju i to je, mislim, suština i taj bend i naši prijatelji, niko tu nije pravio tu podelu, ne moramo mi ništa da se odlučimo, to prosto je jako jednostavno, nekako sve to čovjek prirodno se desi, ne mora ništa da bira i da se složi oko, osim oko jedne stvari. Sećam se, zato sam se setila ime našeg deteta, tu smo se onako jako mnogo, da uskladimo sve neke zahteve svih da. Članova i porodica i kultura i pisanja i svega, ali ovako životne neke stvari mislim da su vrlo slične naše pogledi na stvari i odluke, da.
Why you decided to make a wedding here in Serbia exactly? Because of her, of
yeah,
course.
Yeah, well, because of her, but also because that's important to me. Mm-hmm. So for my wife, but for myself, because that's important to me. That's we kind of mix our cultures and backgrounds equally a bit and effectively, and get to experience the best of both, and also for our families. I don't know, a wedding is one of those rare occasions where you have an excuse to make everybody get together and to make everybody travel. Sometimes, even if they want to, sometimes you have to give them that excuse to come together. And so my parents came, my sisters came, my aunt came to Serbia. I had two friends who came as well. And it was really good opportunity in that regard. So that was part of it. And then also there's the traditions here. And for my wife, I'm sure that's what she looked forward to a lot, or what she imagined a lot. So I think it's important to recognize that and to, you know, give that chance if you can to have that experience.
Kako ste se dogovorili oko imena za dete?
Pa to je bilo onako, posljednji čas smo se dogovorili, pa prvo ime onako izabrano da koje je univerzalno ime, ali se piše na srpskom. A drugo ime smo izabrali u nekom momentu kada se urodio, pa nam je došla neka ideja i onda smo ipak, i onda nas je to povelo. I tako i u suštini sve ostale stvari nekako. Pokušavamo da imamo instinktivnu neku reakciju, da onda idemo sa tim, da nas mnogo ne guše neka mišljenja i neki možda očekivanja.
What they think about Serbia, your family, friends?
I think it was a bit like me. At first impression, it's a bit overwhelming because it's a strong culture a lot. And very expressive, but they enjoyed it, I think, a lot. People are very kind and warm and welcoming, and they always want to show you and share things with you. So I think it's really hard not to like Serbia in that regard. It's very much a country that wants to include you in what's going on and to show you everything, so it's great.
Da li uči srpski, engleski, kako razgovar?
Da, pa oba jezika. Sad još ne razgovara, još je mali, ali oba jezika su prisutna u kući i čak i kineski, zato što mu je vaspitačica u obdaništu kineskinja i onda on priča, mislim ne priča, nego razume kineski, tako da svi jezici su prisutni. Moja drugarica iz Brazila priča s njim portugalski. Ja i mislim da i treba da on čuje sve jezike i ruski mu puštamo neke crtane filmove, tako da ne znam, mislim da nema granica.
Tell me something about your work, please.
So I just finished my PhD this year in Canada. My area of study is biological sciences, and specifically I look at medical genetics and a component of the cells, the telomeres, which is DNA that changes depending on how cells grow and things like this. So it's very specific. But I like all of science and medicine in particular, that type of biology. So now I'm trying to continue the work I did during my PhD and see where I can take that.
Studirala sam isto biološke nauke, smer molekularna biologija, i onda sam na master u Švedskoj bila na biomedicini. I posle toga zapravo došla ovde i radila dve godine u jednoj klinici i specijalizovala se iz oblasti humane reprodukcije, embriologije, vantelesna oplodnja. Tako da sad doktorat je dalje povratak u Kanadu i rad na tome.
Could you work that in Serbia?
Yes and no, it's a little tricky because where the area I work in requires a lot of infrastructure around you. And unfortunately, some of that infrastructure is not so developed here. Mm-hmm. I mean, even in Canada, we're maybe not the highest in that type of development, but we have more infrastructure and research institutes and universities around, so that helps. But then on the other hand, a lot of what I'm doing now is on a computer, so there is a bit of freedom in that regard, where I'm not quite restricted to a particular location.
Da li su mnogo bolji uslovi za rad za tu oblast u Kanadi?
Pa studiranje, ja bih rekla da je možda udobnije, lakše, možda sve onako spremno studentima, ne moraju još onako i sve to klizi i lako je. Uslovi, mislim da je do čoveka u suštini na kraju kako napravi. Ja sam imala tu sreću da posle u toj nekoj specijalizaciji u toj oblasti imam jako dobru priliku ovde u Srbiji u klinici da se edukujem. Tako da bih onda rekla da je taj period bio bolji ovde čak nego u Kanadi. Zavisi od nekih prilika koje čovek mora sam da sebi da pronađe neki put. Tako da generalno možda da. Edukacija, doktorat. Ja sam se onda vratila na doktorat i to mislim da, da sam to odlučila zašto je tamo bolje. Ali poslovi i neki privatan biznis koji i ta vantelesna oplodnja ovde, ja sam imala fenomenalnu opciju i priliku, tako da to mislim da je bolje čak nego tamo.
Tell me something about your hometown.
Okay, I grew up in a place called Puslinch, which has a hilarious name, a little bit. And I went, it's actually a small place in between three or four bigger cities. So for me, I kind of grew up in the countryside. It's a bit rural, not completely rural, but rural enough. We had three neighbor houses, and then the next closest friend when I was growing up was about 5 kilometers away down the road. So for me, the famous thing for Aberfoyle is that we got a Tim Hortons at one point, which is a donut chain in Canada, a donut and coffee chain. And when you get a donut at Tim Hortons, you know you've kind of made it as a little town or city. So when we got a Tim Hortons in the area, it was kind of like, yeah. And then we also have Guelph, which is about 15-20 minutes from where I grew up by car. And Guelph is a university town. It's very much kind of, especially now that we're students, we're part of that culture, the university culture, and it's a large part of the town.
To mesto gde sam ja otišla je bilo onako tiho, prazno, srednja škola, koja je drugačiji ljudi, strašno u početku, da.
Koliko ti je trebalo vremena da se adaptiraš?
Jao, ne znam, to sad kad pomislim, pa možda sada tek nakon dobijanja porodice, osnivanja porodice, ja se osjećam onako lepo tamo.
Kao svoj na svome.
Da, da. I dobila sam i državljanstvo u međuvremenu i tako. U suštini sada se osjećam onako udobno.
What you bring from Canada to Serbia and what would you like to bring from Serbia to Canada?
So when I bring from Canada to Serbia, of course we have maple syrup. I like to bring that. It's nice. We also have ice wine we're famous for. That's a nice present. It's a bit more expensive, but it's delicious and unique. And then I also take beer now, because especially university student. And we have a lot of, in Canada, we have a lot of now kind of craft beers starting. So you have lots of different flavors and kind of interesting things. And everybody in Serbia loves beer, so it's a great present to bring.
Of course.
Maple syrup, sometimes they're not sure what to do with it. Beer, everybody knows what to do with beer, so it's it's pretty easy.
And Serbian beer,
yeah, it's good. I like, it's nice. I like Lav and Jelen. They're decent beers. And I like Nikšiško, Tamno. That's a nice beer. That's one I take back to Canada. Or if my wife comes for a visit to Serbia, she brings some back for me.
How much you can bring with yourself?
The limit is 8 liters if it's beer. So you can take a decent amount. If you're trying to bring rakia, you only get 1 liter. So
sometimes rakia, sometimes beer.
Yeah, or you know, half a liter of rakia and a few beers. So
can you compare a little bit living there and living here? What is similar? What is different?
Sure. So, I mean, I think for me right now, a lot of when you ask that question, it's about the commonality is trying to find a place in the world. So in Canada, we're, my wife and I are trying to find where we fit in. And it's not even limited to Canada so much anymore. It's really the world where we're trying to find, are we going to stay in Canada for a while? Where in Canada? Do we try and go to Europe? Where in Europe? And, you know, what type of jobs do we want? And I think that in Serbia, the young people here, or people our age here, have a lot of the same questions and are asking themselves the same things, you know. What opportunities are here in Serbia for me? What opportunities are outside of Serbia for me? Do I go? Do I stay? So they're not easy questions, I think. So there's, I think, that commonality. The difference is that, I think, coming from Canada, we have, or I have, different options available to me. And that maybe it will take me less work to get to certain places than somebody from Serbia. You know, English is the international language. I have the advantage that way. The educational institutions, even if the level of the education is the same, maybe this institution in Canada is more easily recognized, and therefore it's going to be an easier time for me to move somewhere else or take my degree somewhere else. So I'd say that's one of the big differences.
Kakvi su planovi za budućnost?
Pa da, pa to je jako teško pitanje, ne znam. Planovi su da uživamo što više, vidimo što više možemo. Ceo svet nekako nam je otvoren i tako gledamo na stvari, nemamo potrebu. Znamo da ćemo morati imati negde dom i zbog deteta, da ćemo morati da ima neku sigurnost i neko okruženje ustaljeno, ali bitno nam je da su ljudi koji su nam dragi oko nas i onda čak i njima želimo da pokažemo da sve to, da nije ni važno u stvari, da svuda ima nešto lepo i nešto što manje lepo, ali da ako nas posao vede u Japan da bi išli tamo, nekako nemam uopšte potrebu da sad to nekako još uvek definišem.
What will be the main reason for you to come back to Serbia and maybe to live here one day?
In a social and community sense, Serbia has a very strong community and kind of people interact a lot and people are really part of your life here. In Canada, we tend to maybe be a bit more private. And I find that a little hard sometimes. And that's one of the things I like a lot about Serbia is people here are very open, like I said. They really want to share life, share experiences. And so that's really a nice part here. And even the way the cities are set up and things like this, I find it's very livable. It's, you know, the European city is much more everything mixed together. It's about life. In Canada, everything is a bit more separated. You have the shopping area, you have the working area, you have the living area. And you can have suburbs that go on for kilometers practically, and it's just houses. Whereas here, you go down to the streets, there's shops, there's cafes, people are sitting outside. It's, that part is really nice. So that's a real major draw for Serbia. Plus, obviously, my wife's family is from here. There's a history here. There's places that are special. There's places that are beautiful. I mean, on a world level, Fruška Gora is gorgeous and unique. And it's nice to be so close to everything in Europe. I mean, for Serbians, maybe it's not so close to Paris or something like this, but coming from Canada, to go on a plane for 2 hours and be in Paris, that's amazing as well. So that's another draw.
Serbia je uvek tu, dolazak na nekoliko meseci, godinu dana.
Da, to je baterije se pune tu, da. Hrana, ljudi, prijatelji, da, to su neke stvari koje su neke ukorenjene u čoveku i da on mora da to ispuni tu kvotu svoju i da ode na more i da ima tu rutinu, da, svakako.
Da, sjajno. Želim vam da proputujete ceo svet, svuda da radite, da uživate i da ste što češće ovde.
Da.
I svima će biti super sigurno.
Da, sigurno.
Hvala najveće.
Hvala.